Yeah, good afternoon to one and all. In last class, we seen about the inverting and non-inverting operational amplifiers or working of inverting and non-inverting operational amplifier. Okay, so the first thing is inverting operational amplifier. The objective of designing our inverting operational amplifier is to invert the signal which we are applying. Okay, so the purpose of inverting operational amplifier is to produce a output voltage. This output voltage is the reverse of the input voltage what we applied. Okay, so the output voltage is inversion for the input voltage. So the circuit configuration of our inverting operational amplifier should be like this. This is an operational amplifier consisting of inverting, non-inverting and output terminals. Okay, and we are connecting a feedback resistance RF from output terminal to the inverting input terminal, and we are applying an input signal V input to the inverting terminal of our operational amplifier through a input resistance R1. Okay, so this is an inverting amplifier circuit because of we are grounding the non-inverting terminal to the zero voltage. So non-inverting terminal is grounded as seen in this figure. Okay, so how it will work? Okay, the output voltage we can calculate by a mathematical modulation. We can set our operational amplifier definitely gives an inverting output. Okay, we can judge this output as the inversion of the input voltage by doing the mathematical calculation. Okay, before going to do the mathematical calculations, we have to remember some basic things. Those are the voltages which we are occurred at this inverting and non-inverting terminals, nothing but V1 and V2 voltage magnitudes always should be in equal values. The magnitude of V1 voltage and the magnitude of V2 voltage should be equal to zero, because of in ideal operational amplifier, the offset currents or biasing currents values should be zero. That's why zero biasing currents will flow through the inverting and non-inverting terminals. That zero biasing currents can be possible when the voltage magnitudes at these two terminals can be equal. Nothing but V1 magnitude, voltage at the non-inverting terminal magnitude is equal to voltage at the inverting terminal. Okay, so V1 is equal to V2 always. So that's why this point is called as virtual earthing point. Virtual earthing point means the voltage which is occurred at this point is zero, because of the magnitudes of V1 and V2 should be equal to zero. That's why it is indirectly connected to the ground. Okay, so let me see the mathematical calculation. If you reconnect this entire circuit as like our potential divider, this is our operational amplifier and this is a feedback resistance, this is the input resistance. V input is applied at this point, we are taking V output at this point, and this non-inverting terminal is grounded, right? Okay, if you see the total voltage which is existing in these two resistances R1 and RF is V input minus V output voltage. That magnitude of voltage can be distributed across these two resistances R1 and RF. So these two resistors can work like as a potential divider. Okay, and I quantity of current is flowing through the both resistances R1 and RF. Okay, same magnitude of current I will flow. These two are connected in series. Because of the current through this inverting terminal value is zero, offset current value is zero. So from this we can write the expression for current I is equal to input voltage minus output voltage, or total voltage across these two resistances, divided by total resistance, nothing but sum of two resistors R1 plus RF. And we know that I is equal to V input minus, we can write the expressions for current in the individual resistances. I would like to write the current expression for this resistor, current expression for this resistance. Both the resistors will flow the same quantity of current. That's why I is equal to, particularly current through this resistance is equal to voltage drop across this resistor divided by resistance. Voltage drop is V input minus V2. by R1. Here voltage drop is V2 minus V out. Okay, so I is equal to V input minus V2 divided by R1. Again, same current I is equal to V2 minus V out divided by RF. We already said the potential at this non-inverting terminal is equal to potential at this inverting terminal. Potential at this non-inverting terminal is 0 volts because of this is grounded. Okay, so the potential at this inverting terminal V2 is also 0. Okay, so let me substitute V2 is equal to 0 in this expression. Okay, in this expression, so V input minus 0 by R1 is equal to 0 minus V out divided by RF. From this, I can eliminate this 0 term. V input minus R1 is equal to minus V out divided by RF. Our intention is finding the expression for output voltage. That's why V out divided by V input is equal to minus RF divided by R1. Always the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage is called as the gain value. So the gain of our inverting operational amplifier is minus RF divided by R1, negative of ratio of feedback resistance to the input resistance. And the voltage expression, output voltage expression will becomes minus RF divided by R1, nothing but some gain into input. Okay, here the negative sign indicates output voltage is inverted. If you apply a positive voltage, we get a negative voltage. Okay, or if you apply a sinusoidal signal, we get a same sinusoidal signal with a phase displacement of 180 degrees or one peak. Okay, so the conclusion is, if you maintain this RF and R1 values in same values, then this gain value should be equal and output voltage is completely negative of the input voltage. Here the negative sign indicates that the output is inverted or it maintains 180 degrees phase displacement with the input waveform or input signal. So our objective is completed. Okay, so this configuration will produce as an inverted output at this output terminals. Okay, so the next concept is non-inverting amplifier. So objective of non-inverting operational amplifier is should produce the output voltage. That output voltage is same sign as the input voltage. If you apply a positive signal, the output signal is should also be in positive mannerism. If you apply a negative signal, we get output signal is also a negative signal. Okay, and this is the configuration. Here we have to apply the input signal to the non-inverting terminal because of this configuration is non-inverting operational amplifier. That's why we are going to apply the input signals to this non-inverting input terminal, and this inverting terminal will goes to grounded. Okay, all we have to ground the connection of this inverting input terminal, and R1 is the input resistance of this inverting terminal. RF is the feedback resistance. Always we have to use a negative feedback. If it is a non-inverting operational amplifier, we doesn't give the feedback to this non-inverting terminal. Always the feedback is always be with the inverting terminal only, because of this inverting feedback will give us stability by maintaining proper value of gain. Okay, this negative feedback will limit the gain value and gives good stability of the system. That's why you can always maintain a negative feedback in our operational amplifier circuits. Okay, so we are giving the input signal, some V input signal, to this non-inverting terminal. Okay, let me see whether the output is non-inverting or inverting by calculating the mathematical analysis. In this mathematical analysis also, you should remember that voltage at this inverting terminal is equal to voltage at this non-inverting terminal. Okay, that is basic thing. Okay, if you see the mathematical evaluation, the circuit can be represented like this as a potential divider. Input resistance R1, feedback resistance RF, both are connected to the inverting terminal. Non-inverting terminal is connected to the V input. Okay, this is V output signal, and this inverting terminal is connected to the ground terminal. Okay, and next If you follow the voltage division rule, okay, this is the V1 voltage appeared across the resistance R1. This is total voltage is output voltage. Output voltage minus V1 voltage is the voltage drop across RF resistor. First, I would like to express the V1 voltage by potential division rule or voltage division rule. V input is equal to R1 divided by R1 plus RF into total voltage is V out. Okay, and next we already said voltage at this point is equal to voltage at this point. Voltage at this point is V input, whatever the input signal we are applying. So this V1 voltage is equal to the input voltage. So from this V input voltage is equal to, already we derived the expression for V1, that is R1 divided by R1 plus RF into V out. Okay, from this we can write V input divided by V output, ratio of input voltage to the output voltage is R1 divided by R1 plus RF. Let me reverse this expression. Output voltage to the input voltage ratio is equal to R1 plus RF divided by R1. Okay, from this V out divided by V input is equal to R1 and R1 get cancelled. So 1 plus RF divided by R1. Okay, so this is the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage. So that's why it is called as gain value. So the gain value of our non-inverting operational amplifier is 1 plus RF divided by R1. And the expression for gain of non-inverting operational amplifier is minus RF to R1, minus RF divided by R1. And the gain expression for inverting operational, non-inverting operational amplifier is 1 plus RF divided by R1. Okay, from this output voltage is equal to 1 plus RF divided by R1 into input voltage. There is no negative sign here. Okay, that's why the output is also be positive value if you apply the input as positive. If you apply a negative input, the output is also a negative value. So we can maintain the sign of output voltage as the sign of input voltage. So that's why it is called as non-inverting operational amplifier. Whatever the input we are applying, same sign of output we are getting. So that's why it is called as non-inverting operational amplifier. If you maintain this RF value and R1 values, magnitudes are same, then we get V output is equal to 2 times of V input, or we can maintain the proper values of R1 and RF. We can maintain the different values of gain. Okay, so the output is positive thing and which is in phase with the input supply. So these two concepts we already seen in the last class. Okay, and the next concept is we can design our inverting and non-inverting operational amplifiers with multi inputs. Okay, here the question is it possible, can we design our inverting and non-inverting amplifiers with multiple input signals? Okay, here we are designed already, but this inverting and non-inverting operational amplifiers with a single input signal only. Okay, that single input signal is applied to either inverting terminal or the non-inverting terminal. Okay, the same things can be possible with multi input signals also. So we can design our inverting circuit with multiple input signals, and we can design our non-inverting amplifier circuits with multiple input signals. Okay, so the next concept is inverting summing amplifier. Okay, the next concept is inverting summing amplifier, means which can produce an inverting output. That inverting output is the sum of all the inputs which we are applying. Okay, so this inverting summing amplifier will produce the output signal. That output signal is negative of sum of all the inputs which we are applying. Okay, so the circuit diagram of inverting summing amplifier should be like this. The name itself, it is inverting amplifier, inverting summing amplifier. That's why we have to apply the input signals to this inverting terminal only. We have to apply this apply the inputs or the number of inputs through this negative terminal only. So here we are applying V1, V2, V3, or we can apply n number of input voltages. Here we are taking n value as 3. So V1, V2 and V3 voltage waveforms are V1, V2, V3 signals through this inverting terminal. Okay, we are applying V1, V2, V3 signals to this inverting terminal through the resistances R1 and R2 and R3 respectively. And RF is the feedback resistance which is connected from the output to the input terminal. R compensation, the resistance which is connected to non-inverting terminal is R compensation. In ideal operational amplifier, we don't have compensation resistances, but in practical operational amplifiers, all the practical operational amplifiers having this compensation resistance. Because of to maintain the currents through this inverting and non-inverting terminals should be zero. Okay, in order to maintain the currents through the inverting and non-inverting terminals should be zero. Or we can maintain the voltages at these points A and B, or at this point negative and positive, be equal magnitudes by using this compensation resistance in practical. Okay, so our compensation value is always parallel value or parallel combination value of feedback resistance to the input resistances. Okay, input resistances are R1, R2, R3, feedback resistance is RF. So this compensation resistance is parallel combination of all these four resistances. Okay, so V1, V2, V3 are the input voltages applied through these resistances R1, R2, R3 through this non-inverting terminal. RF is the feedback resistance. R compensation is the compensation resistance which is connected to the non-inverting input terminal. And this value is parallel combination of all these four resistances. Okay, so let me see the mathematical evaluation for this network. We just apply a KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, at this node A. Okay, what said the Kirchhoff's current law? Algebraic sum of all the currents, or the sum of the currents entering at a node is equal to the sum of leaving currents. Okay, or the algebraic sum of all the currents at a node is equal to zero. Okay, so the currents which we are flowing in our operational amplifier are some current I1 is flowing like this, I2 current is flowing like this, I3 current is flowing like this, and feedback current IF is flowing like this. Okay, these are the currents from these input terminals and the feedback terminals, right? So I1, I2 and I3 values. Okay, and this is the feedback current IF. Okay, we can say from this KCL, I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus IF is equal to 0 because of all the currents are entering at this node A. Okay, so I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus IF is equal to 0. What should be the value of I1? I1 is nothing but voltage at this resistance divided by resistance. Okay, so I1 is equal to V1 divided by R1. I1 is equal to V1 divided by R1. I2 is equal to V2 divided by R2. So I2 is equal to V2 divided by R2. I3 is equal to V3 divided by R3. I3 is equal to V3 divided by R3. Okay, and IF is equal to V0. IF is equal to V0 divided by RF. Actually, the current is V1 minus VA divided by R1, V2 minus VA divided by R2, V3 minus VA divided by R3, V0 minus VA divided by RF. But the VA value is equal to 0 because of no voltage is applied to this non-inverting terminal. Voltage applied to this non-inverting terminal is 0 volts. That's why voltage at this point is 0 volts, and voltage at this node A is also 0. That's why we can write V1 minus 0 as V1 by R1 plus V2 by R1 plus V3 by R1 plus V0 by RF. Okay, so this is the expression. Okay, Next, we can write the expression for output voltage. Okay. Next, we can write the expression for output voltage from this above equation. V naught divided by Rf is equal to minus of V1 divided by R1 plus V2 divided by R2 plus V3 divided by R3. From this, V naught is equal to, if you take Rf term to this RHS side, minus of Rf into V1 divided by R1 plus V2 divided by R2 plus V3 divided by R3. Okay, when R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R3 is equal to Rf, if you maintain all these four resistance values should be equal, then we get V0 expression becomes minus Rf into V1 divided by R1 plus V2 V1 divided by Rf plus V2 divided by Rf plus V3 divided by Rf. This denominator Rf will cancelled with this Rf. Okay, finally we get the output voltage is equal to minus of V1 plus V2 plus V3. V1 plus V2 plus V3 is the sum of all the inputs which we are applying to this inverting terminal. Okay, sum of all the inputs which we are applying at this inverting terminal. Okay, so we judge that the output voltage is equal to V0 is equal to inversion of sum of all the input voltages. Inversion, we can say inversion is possible by seeing this negative terminal. If you get an from this negative sign, okay, if you get a negative sign, that negative sign is always indicates the inversion operation. So we can find the output voltage as inversion of all these input voltages. So the application of inverting summing amplifier is possible with this type of configuration. If you design the circuit like this, then we can achieve the intention of inverting summing amplifier. Okay, so the next thing is non-inverting summing amplifier. Okay, non-inverting summing amplifier means which can produce the output voltage. That output voltage is only the sum of input voltages. Okay, whatever the sign of input voltage which we are applying, the same sign we can gain, we can get at this output also. Okay, the name itself, it is non-inverting. That's why we can apply all the inputs to this non-inverting terminal, means positive terminal. Okay, and this inverting terminal is to be grounded. This inverting terminal is to be grounded. And resistances, this is feedback resistance, this is input resistance of this inverting terminal. Okay, non-inverting terminal having three inputs, V1, V2, V3, through the three resistances R1, R2 and R3. We are applying V1, V2, V3 voltages to this non-inverting terminal through the resistances R1, R2 and R3. Okay, so let me calculate the output voltage. Before going to calculate the output voltage, you should remember that what should be the voltage appeared at this non-inverting terminal, same voltage will be appeared at this inverting terminal also. The potential drops at this inverting terminal and non-inverting terminals always be equal in magnitude. Okay, so V, what is voltage appeared at this point? VA. Same voltage is appeared in this inverting terminal also. Okay, so VA, same voltage will be exist. Okay, so let me see the mathematical analysis. The mathematical analysis is related to the KVL. If you apply KVL here, some I1 quantity of current is flowing through R1 resistance, I2 quantity of current is flowing through the R2 resistance, I3 quantity of current is flowing through the R3 resistances. Okay, sum of all these currents I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to zero. Okay, the current flowing through this first resistance is V1 minus VA is the voltage drop across this resistance. That's why V1 minus VA divided by R1. So the first current is V1 minus VA divided by R1, and the second current is V2 minus VA divided by R2 plus third current is V3 minus VA divided by R3. Okay, now let me separate the terms. VA, let we separate the VA term in the above expression. We get V1 by R1 plus V2 by R2 plus V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3 is equal to this term, this term, this term. Can we take these three terms into the RHS side and take VA value as common is equal to VA into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay. So from this, we can write the VA expression. VA will becomes this whole term divided by this term. 1 divided by R1 plus 1 divided by R2 plus 1 divided by R3. So the expression for VA is this entire term whole divided by this term. Okay, so this term. Okay, next. Our intention is to find the output voltage. Okay, this is the at this point we can gain the output. Okay, so if you apply the voltage division rule for this branch, because of the current through this negative terminal is zero, so this current and this current should be equal. Our V naught voltage is divided across this feedback resistance and input resistance. Okay, because of voltage appeared at this terminal is zero, this is neutral terminal, this is V naught voltage. So total V naught voltage will be dropped across this R and RF resistances. Okay, so from if you apply the voltage division rule, V naught output voltage or voltage across this feedback resistance is equal to 1 plus RF divided by R into VA. Okay, we can gain this formula by doing, okay, let me take a pen. Okay, the output voltage V naught is equal to, actually output voltage is equal to some current I into feedback resistance RF, right? Current, the expression for current is again V naught divided by R plus RF. Okay, if you substitute V naught again cancel. Okay, the input voltage, sorry, V naught minus V. Sorry. Let me do. The output voltage V naught is equal to 1 plus RF divided by R, 1 plus RF divided by R into VA, right? Okay, because of the current, here the current is V naught minus VA divided by RF. The current flowing through this feedback resistance is V naught minus VA divided by RF. Okay, so from that, from voltage division rule, we get V naught as 1 plus RF divided by R into VA. Okay, we know VA value very well from the above expression. So V naught is equal to 1 plus RF divided by R into, if you substitute this entire term, okay, this can be the total expression. Okay, I would made R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R3, and which is equal to R, and again which is equal to half of the feedback resistance. I will substitute R1, R2, R3 values with the R value, and R value with the, this R value with RF divided by 2 value. Okay, then what will happen? This 1 by R plus 1 by R plus 1 by R, totally it is 3 by R. Okay, and this RF as, and this RF as 2 times of R. From this RF as 2 times of R. So RR get cancelled. 2 plus 1 is 3. Okay. 3 and 3 by R. Okay. 3, 3 get cancelled. Okay. This R1 as R. This R2 as R. This R3 as R. Totally we get a single R. R and R get cancelled. Finally we get output voltage V0 is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So the output voltage which is appeared at this output terminal is sum of all the input voltages which we are applying to this inverting terminal. Okay, so the output voltage is sum of all the input voltages. So we achieved the purpose of our inverting summing amplifier. So the purpose of our inverting summing amplifier is, sorry, non-inverting summing amplifier is, we can get the output voltage as sum of all the input voltages. So, okay. So we achieved this thing also. Okay, and the next concept is difference operational amplifier. Difference operational amplifier. Okay, so in this operational amplifier, the output voltage is the difference of two input voltages. Okay, so this operational amplifier is designed to perform the output voltage as difference between the two input voltages which we are applying. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram of our operational amplifier. Okay, and this Vi is the voltage at this inverting terminal. Vb is the voltage at this non-inverting terminal. You remember that always Va is equal to Vb at all the cases. Okay, Va is equal to Vb, and we are applying input voltage V1 to this inverting terminal through a resistance R1, and V2 is another input signal which is applying to this non-inverting input terminal through a resistance R2. Okay, and R3 is the feedback resistance which is connected across this output to the input terminal. Okay, okay, these are the elements which are connected to our operational amplifier. Okay, let me see the mathematical analysis for this configuration. Okay, we have to evaluate the mathematical calculation, or we can go through a mathematical calculation by following a superposition theorem. Okay, what superposition theorem states? That the superposition theorem states that the response of any system is equal to the sum of individual responses of that system. So same thing we have to follow here. So the total output is equal to output produced due to this first input and output produced due to second input. Okay, the total output of our circuit is equal to the sum of the outputs produced by this first input and produced by this second input. Okay, if you take V1 as into the account, V2 value should be zero. If you take V2 into the account, V1 value should be zero. Okay, if you add to V1 value, then V2 value is equal to zero. Okay, and if you add to V2 second voltage source, V1 value is zero. Okay, from the basis of superposition theorem. So can we apply a superposition principle for this circuit? In first case, I am taking V1 source as active and V2 source as absent, means V2 voltage is zero and I am applying V1 voltage. Okay, then what will happen? This can completely work as an inverting amplifier. Okay, if V2 value is equal to zero, only inverting input is applied to this negative terminal. Okay, this entire circuit can works like as a inverting amplifier and produces output voltage, that is ratio of feedback resistance to the input resistance into V input signal minus of R3 divided by R1 into V out. Okay, let me see this analysis also, calculation also. Okay, if this current, if this voltage V2 is equal to zero, then I2 value is also zero and VB value is also zero and VA value is also zero. Okay, so the current I1 is equal to, actually current I1 is equal to V1 minus VA divided by R1, and feedback current IF is equal to VA minus V output A, case A. In case A, the output which is appeared at this terminal is V output A divided by RF. We know this VB is equal to zero because of V2 is zero. If VB is zero, VA is also zero. Okay, so substitute VA is equal to zero in our above expression. I1 is equal to IF, already we know. Same quantity of current is flowing through these two resistances because of current through this inverting terminal is zero. Okay, so because of I1 is equal to IF, and if you substitute VA value is equal to zero in this expression, VA is equal to zero in this expression, V1 divided by R1 is equal to minus VA minus V out of A divided by R3. Okay, output voltage in case A is equal to minus of R3 divided by R1 into V1. Okay, if you see the case 2, in case 2 we can add to the V2 source and V1 source can be disconnected. V1 value as 0 and V2 is taken into the account. So in case B, V2 is active and V1 is absent. Okay. So in that case, if V2 is present, the value of this VB as, according to the voltage division rule, R4 divided by R2 plus R4 into input voltage. According to voltage division rule, voltage at this resistance R4 is VB is equal to R4 divided by total resistance R2 into R2 plus R4 into input voltage V2. So VB expression will becomes R4 divided by R2 plus R4 into V2. We know this point can always maintain at same potentials. So that's why VB is equal to VA, and again VA value is equal to VB is equal to VA. Okay. And we can write the expression for VA by using these two resistances. Okay. So the VA expression is again by following the potential division rule, R1 divided by R1 plus R3 into V out. So R1 divided by R1 plus R3 into V out. Okay. Substitute VA value in this expression, VB value in this above expression. So VB as this thing. Okay. Okay. I write in that thing here. R4 divided by R2 plus R4 into V2 is equal to VA is equal to this thing. R1 divided by R1 plus R3 into V out. Okay, so V output in case B is equal to R4 into R2 plus R4 into V2. This I think can be reversed. If you go this side, this is R4 plus R3. Only R1 term will be presented. Only R1 term will present. R1 plus R3 divided by R1 into R4 divided by R2 plus R4 into V2, right? If you maintain R1 is equal to R2 and R3 is equal to R4, means two input resistance values should be equal and feedback resistance and this compensation resistance value should be equal. R1 is equal to R2, R3 is equal to R4. Then this expression becomes, okay, R1 is equal to R2 and R3 is equal to R4. In R2 place, we can write R1. In R4 place, we can write R3. So this term and this term get be cancelled. Okay, in R4 place, we can write R3. So this is R3 divided by R1. So the output voltage is R3 divided by R1 into V2. So the output in case B is equal to R3 divided by R1 into V2. And the output at case A is equal to minus R3 divided by R1 into V1. Okay. So the total output is equal to sum of individual outputs. So V output is equal to output voltage at case A plus output voltage at case B, right? So V output is equal to minus R3 divided by R1 into V1 plus R3 divided by R1 into V2. So V output is equal to R3 divided by R1 into V2 minus V1. If you take R3 by R1 term as common, output voltage is equal to R3 by R1 into V2 minus V1. So what we concluded from this above expression, the output voltage is always proportional to the difference of two input signals which we are applying, V2 minus V1. Okay, if you take R3 by R1 value as some constant K, V output is directly proportional to the difference of two inputs. Okay, difference of inputs which we are applying to this non-inverting and inverting terminals are, and if you maintain this non-inverting terminal input value as higher than this inverting terminal input value, then the output is positive. If V2 value is greater than the V1 value, okay, non-inverting input signal magnitude is greater than the inverting signal magnitude, then the output is positive thing. Okay. If you maintain this inverting terminal input value is higher than this non-inverting terminal value, if V1 is greater than the V2, then we get a negative output. If you maintain both these signals with same magnitude, V1 and V2 V1 and V2 of with same magnitude, then we get a zero output. Okay, so the conclusion from this is the output voltage is always proportional to the difference of two input signals. If V2 is greater than the V1, we get a positive output. If V1 is greater than V2, we get a negative output. If you maintain V1 is equal to V2, our two input signals as same, then we get a zero response for this circuit. Okay, so this is about our today class.
Additional clip was the problem in Ledu.